Hi guys, welcome back to my channel Shree's Blissfully Yum. I'm back with yet another episode of Twins Tiffin Diaries. In today's episode, I'm going to show you a regular recipe in my twins' Sunday tiffin box, soft and fluffy idlis with yummy onion chutney. A South Indian breakfast item, idli is very common in our household, but people feel it's a daunting task to get perfect idlis every time. Let me tell you, if you get the proportion and consistency of the batter correct, the idli batter can be a lifesaver. I prepare the batter on weekends and prefer to have them handy whenever I am out of options for the twins' tiffin box. Follow my recipe step by step and you will get soft, fluffy idlis every time. And the onion chutney, it's lip smacking. Many of my friends have already tried this recipe. It's just 4 ingredients and it's absolutely delicious with the idlis. So let's see how to make them. So let's see how I make the idli dosa batter. On Saturday morning, I soak 3 cups of idli rice, which is also known as parboiled rice, in 5 cups of water. If you do not have idli rice, you can use basmati rice or white rice instead. Also, I will soak 1 cup of urad dal or split black lentils in 2 cups of water. Some recipes might tell you to add methi or fenugreek seeds here. I never do that. My mother never did that. And our idlis come out perfect each time. Both urad dal and the rice will need soaking for at least 6 hours. In the evening, I drain and wash the soaked urad dal thoroughly and add them to my 1 liter blender jar, all of it with 1/2 cup of water or just sufficient water to prepare a fine paste. Point to note guys, urad dal must be ground to a fine paste with thick consistency, so do not be tempted to add more water. I always store my idli dosa batter in these stainless steel containers with lids. These have nice height so the batter won't overflow while fermenting. I can accommodate twice the quantity of this same batter in this particular container. So I'm transferring the urad dal batter to the steel container. This mixy spatula comes handy to take out all the batter from the jar. Now, wash and drain the idli rice. And add 1/2 of it to the blender jar. I'm adding 1/2 cup or just sufficient water to blend the rice. Rice batter will be thinner than the dal batter and will have little coarse texture to it. And that's fine. Never grind the rice batter too fine. So the first 1/2 is ready. Transfer it to the container with the dal batter. Add the rest of the washed rice to the jar and with that add 1/2 cup of boiled rice, that is cooked rice. This can be any type of rice. I had some boiled matta rice with me, so I am adding that. Adding boiled rice is important as it adds to the fluffiness of the idlis. And with that, I am also going to add 1 teaspoon of salt. Add sufficient water to blend the rice. Grind to the same texture mentioned before. I will just show you how to check it. Rub the rice batter through your finger and you will feel finer rice particles. Add the second batch of rice batter to the container. Now, what my mother used to do is, with clean, washed and dried hands, she used to mix the 2 batters and that's what I follow. The warmth of my hand will help in the fermenting process. This is totally optional. You may mix it using a spatula. It's hot here in UAE nowadays and the idli batter ferments really well, just kept overnight on the countertop. But in winters, I keep it inside an oven with the oven light turned on. So it takes almost 10 to 12 hours for the batter to ferment for me. If I grind the batter by 6 pm in the evening, it's fermented by 5 am the next morning. So here you can see the fermented batter. Just give it a good mix one more time before preparing the idlis. Now to prepare the idlis, grease the idli molds with oil, makes it easier to take out the idlis without sticking, and keep 3 cups of water for boiling in the idli pot. Pour the idli batter into the molds, just enough to fill them. When the water comes to a rolling boil in the pot, place the idli molds in it and close the lid. It takes around 12 to 15 minutes to cook the idlis. Just check them with a toothpick or a knife. My idlis are done and they have risen well. I'm taking the mold out from the pot and I will let it cool for 5 minutes. While still warm, take out the idlis using a spoon. Now let the idlis cool completely and let's prepare the onion chutney. This is the easiest chutney and it's my mother's recipe. Peel one onion and cut it into rough chunks. While peeling, do you guys take out an extra layer out or is it just me? Do comment below and tell me. Wash the onion thoroughly before cutting it. Do not forget to cut out the white part as it will make your dish bitter. Add the chopped onions to a chutney jar. With that, I am going to add 1.5 teaspoons of Kashmiri Red Chilli Powder. Note, it is Kashmiri Red Chilli Powder, not the spicy one. And 1/2 teaspoon of salt. Close the lid and pulse it to a coarse paste, not a fine paste. In fact, it's your choice. I prefer the coarse texture. Using a spoon, just bring down the mixture from the sides and pulse again. This is the texture we are looking for. Now add almost 4 tablespoons of coconut oil to this. I am using sunflower oil, but if you have coconut oil, do make this chutney with that. I'm showing you the quickest, easiest microwave method. I will also explain how to make this chutney on stovetop. Just give a quick stir and microwave on high power for 3 minutes. Now on stovetop, use the same quantity of oil and saute the mixture in a pan till you get rid of all the raw smell of the onions. So our chutney is ready. I feel it needs more oil. I am going to add one more tablespoon of oil to this. Let the chutney cool down completely and we will pack the tiffin box now. So here I have diced the idlis to small bite-sized pieces for the twins. With that, I am packing the onion chutney in these round boxes. Now, I pack a small box with little sugar to have the idlis with in case they are not in a mood for a chutney, but you may totally skip it. For vegetables, I am packing steamed broccoli florets and baby carrots. And for a crunchy element, I am adding these goldfish baked cheese crackers. Snack break, I have added 2 pitted medjool dates and 3 to 4 jumbo raisins. And the usual elements, spoon, a fork and 2 towels to place the tiffin on. So the boys are off to school. See you in the afternoon. Guys, the boys are back and here are their tiffin boxes. Anirudh said he didn't get to finish his tiffin because it was too much for him. As you can see, few idlis are left and he has used up some of that chutney, which is actually his favorite. Broccolis are also gone, but he said he didn't like the baby carrots. Few crackers are there, but overall it is fine. He didn't come back hungry and that's important. Now let's see Aniket's tiffin box. His teacher had called up to inform me that he cried in school and was missing his mama and home. So I am a little sad that he was not in a good mood in school today. As you can see, he has barely touched the tiffin box and this makes me even more sad that he came back hungry. Let's see if he wants to eat now. And yes, he does. Initial days can be rough for a toddler in school and the tiffins might come back untouched. Try to explain how much effort you take to pack the tiffins for them and how important it is to not remain hungry in school even if they are sad on a particular day. Aniket wants to finish up his tiffin now. I am happy to see that the snack boxes are empty at least. So all in all, there is a vast room for improvement for them. I hope you will try my recipe for your family and friends. Thank you for watching and if you like this video, do give it a thumbs up. Do tell me in the comment section below if you like this new series. Subscribe to my channel if you are new here. And do click on that notification bell just next to the subscribe button to get notified whenever I upload a new video. And when is that? Every Monday at 4 p.m. See you guys next week. Until then, eat yummy, stay happy.